live it up. Every day you wake up singing, turn it up. The party's just beginning. All together, you and me, carry
the air. Hey, it's Vivian J, and welcome back, Glitter Angels. Welcome to another YouTube video, hashtag WoeSquadForever. So, a lot of you guys are probably looking forward to the 5-minute makeup challenge, but I'm saving that for back to school season, which, by the way, is not quite here yet. It's still summer. To make this video super duper fun, I thought it'd be really interesting to put myself to the test and see if I can do my makeup like the one, the only, James Charles. There's a photo right up here that I'm trying to recreate, which, by the way, is James Charles' bubblegum pop look. So I'm gonna be using that image to basically, like, kind of see where I'm at and also making sure I'm following it as best as I can. If I can't do it, then I tried. So yeah, make sure to click this like button if you enjoyed the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not already and hit the bell for post notifications so you won't miss any new content from me. Without further ado, empecemos! Okay guys, so I'm also using my phone as the second camera, aka my makeup camera, and we're just going to go ahead and get straight on into this makeup. I'm a little bit nervous. Hopefully, I'll do well on this one. First things first is moisturizing, obviously. And next, I'm going to apply my favorite foundation ever, Laura Mercier, baby. And we're going for a full coverage on this makeup look. I haven't really done like a James Charles look on this channel, like ever. I mean, I've used the palette like many times, but I've never created one of his makeup looks. So this is gonna be very, very interesting. And if you wanna try this at home, do it. Now for my favorite concealer, the Tarte concealer. Okay, now we're moving on to the eyeshadow look of the bubblegum pop. So this part is gonna be a little tricky, so I don't know how perfect this may turn out. It may not turn like super perfect, but whatever. So as usual, I'm gonna start off with a white base. By the way, I'm using the James Charles palette and also another makeup palette that I haven't used in a while. So I'm gonna take this white eyeshadow and just apply it over my eyelids. Okay, so for lighter colors, I'm gonna go for a very light pink, which is this one. The color is called Pinkity Dinky, the very pale pink, which is this color. And I'm gonna apply it like, kind of like close toward the middle. I don't know if this may be right, but whatever. Okay, it's not really like showing as what I expected. So, I'm just gonna add like a little bit of the color Skip. So far it looks very promising, I would say. So I haven't really added like the dark and light shades yet. Oh my god, this palette is kind of falling apart, but it's fine. So I'm gonna take one of the pink colors and just kind of like apply it like around like my crease. Oh my goodness. So as I was applying the light pink and also the color Skip from the James Charles palette, when I was applying it all over the lids, I'm like, whoa, I'm starting to get close. I also realized that he added a little bit of purple like on the end. So that's what I'm planning to do as well. So the color I think he might have used is, it's called Escape, which is this dark purple here. Don't know if you guys can see that clearly, but whatever. Okay, and then we're going for a kind of like a purplish at the end. I don't know if he used also black as well, but also I think he might have used a little bit of black. The black is called Spooky. Oh my goodness. I can't believe I actually did that kind of like a pro. So I'm gonna add a little bit of that same color Skip for like a little like shady effect, if that makes sense. Okay, now to add a little bit of more black since it's not really like showing 100%.
So I'm going to be taking my Urban Decay Smoky palette and choose the color Black Market. Okay, it took a lot of shades of pink to complete the eyeshadow, but glad that I managed to complete it, and it actually doesn't look too bad. So now we're going to move on to the brows. Okay, now we're going to move on to contour slash bronzer. I'm going to be taking my BT21 bronzer stick, like down my nose-ish, to add a little bit of like definition to this look. Okay, and for blush, I'm going to apply the peach blush, which is this one from my Ulta palette. I'm going to apply a generous amount on the apples of my cheeks. And it actually does look similar to the blush in the James Charles picture, but probably not. And nothing like a little bronzer, because why not? Alright, now time for mascara! So next I'm going to apply some mascara. I'm going to be taking my Nicole Miller New York Lengthening Mascara. I use two different types as usual. Also, once I did my mascara, I forgot to mention that I also did my eyeliner, as you could already tell already, because that's how probably James Charles did this makeup look. And now for the final step, which is a lipstick. But first, gotta moisturize my lips. Okay, now I'm gonna add my e.l.f. moisturizing pink lipstick, my favorite of all time. Now for highlighter, I'm going to be using the Pearl highlighter, which is this color. And we're done! This is the final look of the James Charles bubblegum pop look, and oh my god, I'm so surprised. I have no words. I have no words. But yeah, it turned out okay. Not as bad as I thought.
So here is the bubblegum pop look inspired by James Charles. I actually did pretty well. I thought it was gonna turn out wrong, but it's not. So I'm gonna call a friend of mine. This is Lily, y'all.
Hey, everyone!
Yeah, we miss each other a lot ever since quarantine.
Miss choir?
Oh yeah, I do miss choir, but at least we might will be in a chorale this coming school year, so that's exciting. I kind of wanted to show you the James Charles inspired bubblegum pop.
Whoa, it looks so good on you!
Thank you. Cause like I was going for like something popping, like still
yeah.
Wild.
Did you follow a tutorial or did you make it up yourself?
Oh, well, I found an image of a James Charles, the bubblegum makeup, and I decided to try it out and see how it works.
It looks really good.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It actually doesn't look too bad, because, I was so surprised that I did the eyeshadow, really perfectly.
Amazing.
Yeah, like, the reason why I decided to call it, because, remember how back in February we were filming for the V-Show vlog?
Yeah, how could I forget?
Yeah, because I remember sometimes like you were holding my vlog camera and you were acting like as if you were like an influencer, which is a funny part. That always cracks me up.
Vlog, you guys should all come.
Hey vlog, I'm Abby. This is Lily.
I've never been a vlogger before.
It seems like they both.
I think it's a natural. It's a natural thing. Oh, my braid's going on.
Yeah.
Yeah. One day I'll get there.
Seems like you and Abby are most likely to become kind of like James Charles-ish.
Abby?
Well, that's my guess. I keep like telling like other people like whether it's like my close friends or like I know a lot of people that are most likely to become YouTubers, believe it or not. Is that true, you guys?
Yeah, I think it is. Do you think I could become a YouTuber?
Well, I mean, I can't say no to that. I mean, I'm telling you, anybody can be a YouTuber. I remember like when I first started, people keep telling me like I can't film, but when I actually can.
Yeah.
They're just being mean, you know?
Oh, you're
Maybe I should, hopefully, like, once, quarantine is over, I might start doing other people's makeup again.
Yeah, you can do mine. That would be amazing.
Well, but, well, our skin shades are kind of different, though. Like, I'm kind of on the darker side.
That's okay.
But it's fine. We may not have the same foundation shade, but...
Oh, no. We can make it work.
Well, see and find out. Do you think I should do her makeup?
Yes, everyone.
I think they might say yes.
Are you filming a video?
Oh yeah, I was filming this for a video. I was trying to get other people's reviews on like how my attempt was at this makeup look.
Amazing. And I can't wait to be featured on your YouTube video.
Well, even though I can't feel your hands, but I can feel your heart.
Aw, I love you, babe.
I love you, too.
Can't wait to see you soon.
See you soon.
Okay, bye.
Toodles.
I think, like, the pink is pretty cool, and it's, like, a really poppy color, so, like, people will notice more. So, yeah, I love the makeup look.
So, that was pretty much the bubblegum poppins makeup look inspired by the one, the only, James Charles. I'm not sure if I'm at... might add a little TikTok or pictures, but here they are anyway. So I work it when I walk down the hallway, they can't say nothing. Oh, 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 my lips so luscious. The way I spice it up with the Mac brushes. L'Oreal got them watermelon crushes. That's probably the reason all these boys got crushes. What you know about me? I said I like it like that. I said I like it like that. I'm just within the chain. Hopefully you've really liked this makeup look, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below because I make weekly videos, and hit the bell for post notifications so you won't miss any new content from me, and also share this video with your friends, spread the word out there, and yeah, love you guys all, to the moon and back, and I'll see you guys later. Toodles! Love you!